Hello there. Welcome to another episode of the 40+Woman. My name is Busola Jegede and I am passionate about issues concerning women. Today we are here with another interesting episode for that woman who is maturing gracefully, for that woman who has spent her years in productive service. Yes, we're talking about the 40+Woman and preparing for retirement as well as reinventing yourself. You know, that's one of the highlights of this program, how you can reinvent yourself. Because as a woman, we have different seasons. And as we move from one season to another, it's important that you know how to remain relevant. It's important that you know how to position yourself. And it's important that whichever stage in your life you're at, you are at an advantage, because you know circumstances in life can put people at a disadvantage. So today we're looking at the 40+Woman planning for that season in her life when she can no longer probably work in a structured office. What are the options available to her? How can she prepare for this? And we have someone in the studio who is going to do justice to this. She has passed through the stages. She's worked in an established organization for many years. And right now, she's reinvented herself. She's relevant and quite fulfilled doing what she loves to do. I'm going to be introducing our guest in a minute. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Hello there, my name is Busola Jegede. I am a John Maxwell certified coach, a consultant, and a chartered accountant. For over 15 years, I've been working with women, helping them to discover their purpose, their vision, holding their hands, seeing them through turning their visions to profitable ventures. And it will be a delight to work with you. Do you feel unfulfilled? Do you feel that there is more to your life? Do you have a story to tell, a book to write, a vision to birth? Are you over 40 or 50? I can assure you that the second half of your life can be better than the first half. Why don't you sign up for my one-on-one coaching session or a strategy session? It will be a joy to work with you to reinvent yourself, to birth a new you. Welcome back. Now, on today's episode of the 40+Woman with Busola Jegede, we have a wonderful woman, a very, very sweet lady. I've known her for many, many years, so I can authentically say that about her, because she's that and much more. We have with us Mrs. Yinka Olatubosun. She's the managing director of Yekoksi Foods. She's based in Lagos, Nigeria, Africa, and it's my pleasure to bring her to the studio today to share with us on her journey in retirement and in reinventing herself. Mrs. Olatubosun, you're welcome to the broadcast.
Thank you so much for having me.
Wow. Tell us a bit briefly about your banking career. How long did you work in the bank? When did you make the transition? What was the journey like for you?
Wonderful. I was in the banking industry for about 27 years before I retired. And because of the challenges of the work and not having enough time for myself, you know, I looked at the issues. And then when it was possible for us, when there was an opportunity, for those of us who wanted to retire, we're given a special package. And my husband said, what are you waiting for? You know, I just took
it. How old were you at that time?
Well, I was 54 at the time when I retired from banking. And it's always good, you know, for you to retire early when you still have the strength, you know, to work. So it's really, really important for you to take advantage of the time when you have your strength, and then of course you can take up the opportunity and then start something of your own that you'll enjoy doing.
So what do you do presently?
Well, I'm a woman of many parts, to the glory of God. Apart from being the MD of Yokoxi Foods, I'm also a minister of the Methodist Church, and I'm in charge of a church. I'm also involved in an interdenominational women's group, Daughters of Destiny, and I still consult, you know, by the fact that the job I do as a minister is part-time. So do the food business, which is really my passion, and then I still consult, I still get, you know, invited, you know, to train bankers on sales and management.
That's so good to know. You're still very, very busy, but now you're at doing things at your own term, at your own pace, and I'm sure you're enjoying it.
Very much.
So now you retired at 54. So for a woman who is nearing 50 in her 40s, will you say that one shouldn't be careless not to make a plan? What would you advise about
that? That's a very good question. Because in life, you have that your aha moment, and you wonder, what are my plans for the future? They say a fool at 40 is a fool forever. So when you get to 40, you've got to look at your life and say, where do I want to be in 5 years, 10 years, and give yourself a target and walk towards the target. And working towards the target means you're looking at your giftings, you're looking at your passion, you're looking at what you will enjoy doing that will help you, you know, to transit into retirement and starting something of your own.
So you've touched on something that is very interesting: gifts, passion, talent. Because many people are working, but they are not really working. They're not doing what is their passion. Probably they're in a career. Maybe somebody is a lawyer because the person went and read law, but that's not really the person's calling. So invariably, when you retire, it's like you go back to your passion, to what you love doing. So can you just give us like a roadmap for anyone who is looking at, okay, my time in this organization, by the time I'm 50 or 55, how do I create a space for myself in future so I transit without losing ground financially?
Once you identify your passion, you identify your giftings, then you need to build yourself up in that area to create value. And most of the time on that retirement, you know, journey, whilst you're working to ensure you save. A lot of people, especially in bank, they give you big upfront income housing and all to ensure that, and of course, big travel allowances you are given when you get to a senior level, business class and all that. We must learn to save so that as you build up, you'll be able to build capacity, opportunities to have educational investment firms, you know, investment in shares, you know, these are things that will help you build up. And then as you're doing that, you're also building on your talents and your giftings. Some of these things you build over time. And as you build over time, some of it you do free, you give free business, free service. And with that, you're developing yourself and creating capacity. And as you build yourself and create capacity, as some people call it the side hustle, you need to build on it. And as you build on it, you create the clientele so that when you are ready to leave, you are not starting afresh. A lot of people leave and they are like lost on what they need to do. Even if they're given so much money, they don't know what to do with the money. But if you've started something, you can always transit and move into it.
You know, you've touched on something very deep. You see a lot of people, they were given upfront, they were given severance packages, retirement bonuses, and then somebody comes with this proposal, maybe all sorts of proposals, things that you're not familiar with. And we've seen a lot of people lose their money because what the project is not really their passion, but they have so much money, they don't know what to do with it. And so it's important what we're discussing today for that 40 plus woman who is watching, you must have a plan. And like Mrs. Olatunbosun has said, you've got to use your time wisely, your resources wisely. Invest in property. Property is something that I know that if you invest in it, when you retire, it can really deliver to you a lot of value. You can get passive income from renting it out. You can even start something in that, on that location. So let's look at those practical things that we need to do as women in order to secure our positions when we retire. You mentioned a side hustle. Mm-hmm. So we've seen some people set up institutions like maybe a nursery school, a primary school. They put people there, professionals there, whilst they are working. Mm-hmm. So that by the time they retire, that particular vision would have grown. Is there any other such thing that women can do in order to hedge their position when eventually they cannot go to those offices again because the biological clock is ticking, and more often than not, there has to be that time that the rubber will hit the road?
First and foremost, anything you go into, you must make sure that you keep learning. Mm. If you are starting school, you learn as to be a teacher. If you are starting a beauty, you learn, you know. And you train yourself to be good at what you're doing so that you can be the best in what you're doing. At the time when I retired, I didn't know I would go into food business. I was thinking, oh, I could go into consulting. I still consult. Mm. And because of that, I became a consultant, you know, a trained, certified trained management consultant. I went for the Brian Tracy training, you know, sales training. I went to Harvard for a leadership, Harvard Business School for a leadership training program. These were things I thought would help me to transit into, you know, being a consultant, where the Brian Tracy is a sales guru, Harvard is, you know, where you get the man. And I thought I would go into that. But the story's changed because food was my passion. Mm. Food was my passion. And, you know, because food was brought out of passion, because at that time, you know, after retirement, there's something else that you also need to do. As you're looking at the area where your business is, you are looking at other things that would affect you to see how you can learn, make sure you update yourself concerning the business you're going into, make sure you have connections to those who will assist you to get what you're going to do. Make sure you create value for people to want to have it. You might start by giving free service, but gradually people will go to appreciate you for who you are, and then they pay for who you are. And they'll look for you wherever you are if you create value. And whether you're working, when you're working, they know you even before you leave. So when you leave, then you become an authority in your area, and it will just be a smooth ride all the way. Yes.
Wow, that's so mind-blowing what you've shared with us. And we have just moved into the second part of this topic of today, which is reinventing yourself. But before we go any further, we're going to be right back. Let's go on a short break. See you in a bit. Hello there, my name is Busola Jegede. I am a John Maxwell certified coach, a consultant, and a chartered accountant. For over 15 years, I've been working with women, helping them to discover their purpose, their vision, holding their hands, seeing them through turning their visions to profitable ventures. And it will be a delight to work with you. Do you feel unfulfilled? Do you feel that there is more to your life? Do you have a story to tell, a book to write, a vision to birth? Are you over 40 or 50? I can assure you that the second half of your life can be better than the first half. Why don't you sign up for my one-on-one coaching session or a strategy session? It will be a joy to work with you to reinvent yourself, to birth a new you. Welcome back to the 40+Woman. My name is Busola Jegede, and I have been speaking with Mrs. Yinka Olatunbosun, the Managing Director, Yekoxi Food. And the topic has been the 40+Woman preparing for retirement and reinventing yourself. Mrs. Olatubosun has been through the journey, having worked in an established banking institution in Nigeria for 27 years, and she retired in senior management position. She's been sharing with us her journey, how she got a severance package at 54, and she started a food processing company. So you're welcome back, Mrs. Olatubosun. We just moved into the second part, reinventing yourself from being a banker. And you thought you were going to be a consultant. You did a lot of training, but God brought you back to your passion, which is food. So what that resonates with me, the way it resonates is that your passion would always be what you fall back on, you know.
Definitely.
Even after going after career, money, fame, you would always come back to what makes you fulfilled. So tell us about your reinvention as the MD of a food processing company. Was that, did it come out of an awakening or a crisis? What made you go into the path of food production?
Very interesting. After retirement, I actually went for, you know, just a normal, you know, medical checkup. And after going the medical checkup, I realized that my blood pressure was high, my blood sugar was high, and I realized my father was diabetic, my mother was hypertensive, and they both died of the diseases. Mm-hmm. So it was an awakening for me, a wake-up call that I needed to do something about. And then I was just putting on so much weight, and I knew I had to take my health seriously. So because of that, I looked at some of the food that would help you to lose weight, bring down your blood sugar and blood pressure. And I used myself as a guinea pig. Using different food, I'll test my blood pressure, test my blood sugar. And that was how I came up with different food items. And sharing with my consultant was something, you can't keep this to yourself. And I shared it with people. I tried it with a woman, one woman who was supposed to travel to India for a liposuction. And she was billed to travel. And I gave her some of the products and it worked for her. When she got to India, the consultant said, can the patient come in? The patient came in. I said, where's the patient? This is the patient. So what happened to you? She said, well, I met a lady and she helped me with my food plan. I said, then you don't need a liposuction. Why don't you continue? She was my first client.
Wow.
And this lady encouraged me. And that was how I went off, did a certification with NAFDAC, started training myself on food and creating food that will help people. And my passion, you know, helped me to create food line. And ultimately, God helped us. We were an award winner at a special program at the Palms, you know, where we had a
at the
prize,
shopping mall.
Yes, okay. At the Palms Mall. So the passion actually now came out to see that's really what I love doing. And I just do it seamlessly, and it's been a wonderful journey for me.
For every 40-plus woman out there, watch out for your passion. You may be working in that organization. Watch out for your passion. That's the main message we've heard from Mrs. Olatubosun now. Now, let's look at how can women reinvent themselves? Can we have like a step-by-step guide? You've said a lot about that in your statement earlier, that you must be ready to learn.
Yeah,
because if you're going into something new, you must be ready to learn. You did certain certifications, and now coming to the food business, you still needed to register with NAFDAC. So I would also say you have to find out the people who are in the space where you want to be. You want to be, you've been working in the office now, you want to go into business, you want to go in as an educator, you want to own a school or a restaurant, or whatever it is that is new that you want to go into, learn about it and find out who are the forerunners, what's going on there, how are they managing it, so that you can learn the ropes. What other steps can you can one take to reinvent oneself?
When we're talking about learning, it's important for you to know that whatever level you're coming from, you must learn from those who are on the job. Hmm. I was coming from a banking line where I was vice president. When I got to the food line, I needed to work with people who were very, very low-level people. Hmm. I had to learn from them. And there's an incubation center where they do the training for you to learn. Hmm. You must be humble enough to learn if it's a new area that you're going into. Secondly, you must ensure that whatever you do it very, very well. You stand out, you know, with excellence performance, you know. I come from a family of many girls, and something my father told me when we were young was that you're a girl, you're an African, and you're from Nigeria. So if you're a woman, a female, you need to do a lot more.
Extra.
So ensure that whatever you do it well. You create value so that people will want what you need. You must be disciplined in all that you do. You must have passion. I talked about the passion. And then you must be relevant to what goes on in your industry. The social media, it's good for you to know what is happening, how it will affect you, what you will do, and what are the other things you need to do. And then you must have a plan, a business plan. A lot of people just go into business without having a plan. Yeah. Where do you want to be in 1 year? Where do you want to be in 10 years? We have a policy that the company I'm targeting, I'm looking at myself as a Nestle of the future. So you're looking at yourself, where do you want to be? And you're not just going to look at yourself that you're operating at a local level. You're looking at how you're operating at an international level.
Global.
So as a global level, what about certifications are you looking at? Now the focus is on organic. Okay, I've got to do organic certification. You know, you've got to build up whatever passion you have. Whether you know how to write books or you want to take care of young people, or you are in fashion business, or whatever passion. Some people are in comedy business. Some people are good at talking. They can become Alaja Ajoku or Laka Duro. You know, these are some of the things.
MCs at
you wedding. Must make sure you stand out to be the best. And you must be confident with what you're doing. You must ensure that you are focused. Exactly. Because there'll be challenges. Certainly. Sometimes there'll be financial challenges. And you must be focused on where your end point is. And not give up. Age is just a number. And don't get yourself concerned that, okay, they are younger people and all. When we went for the Palms promo, I was actually the eldest for that competition. I looked at myself and I saw people were young and survey and all, but that didn't stop me. So you've got to look at yourself and say where you are, play in the space of young people, play and ensure that you be the very best of who you want to be. That's how you make it and make a mark. Wow. So that all that you do, age will just be a number. You'll be a number one in area or your area of calling and passion.
Yes, you've got it right there. You've heard it, 40 plus women. Play in the space of young people. I really like that. Play in the space of young people. I tell a lot of women, the older you grow, the younger you dress. You've got to be intentional about retaining your youth because you must pay attention. Already there is a mind block and there is a lot of resistance and lack of favor for people who are getting older. In the workspace, they are being eased out. People don't want to give people a chance. They believe they're too old, except in some Western countries where age doesn't matter as long as you can do the job. So if you are not intentional about looking young, it will be easy to put a person in a box. So if you want to reinvent yourself, you've heard it there, learn. And it's important that you also update yourself. What are the current trends? You cannot live in a digital world and have an analog mentality. There are things we just have to learn. And I just wanted to say this. it's also important as you're retiring and reinventing yourself to join a community, because networks are powerful.
I was going to talk about networks. Because as we are all social animals, and you've got to look at, like the men, they have their old boys association. You know, for us as women, we've looked at, you know, the church community, your old girls community, your friends and acquaintances, you know, these are areas. And of course, you've got to network to see those who can help you. Some of the alumni of your schools, or alumni of even the organization, some of the banks that I work in, some of them are some of my big customers, you know. So you take advantage of social media, take advantage of relationships, take advantage of networking, take advantage of opportunities given, you know, like this kind of opportunity that people have. Make sure you watch the TV, TVC, for instance, they're giving this wonderful program on what you can do as a 40-plus woman.
Exactly.
In addition to that, as long as you're looking at yourself, you must also be conscious of engaging your brain, engaging your body, reading. And there's a brain power, ensure. Otherwise, you will find yourself just aging. You have to exercise, you have to eat good food. You've got to make yourself relevant. And it's in the mind and in the brain and in the hand. The mind, the brain, and the hand.
The mind, the brain, and the hand. On that note, I want you to please don't go away. We'll be right back, going on a short break.
Infogeosin, blissful honey beans. Rich in protein and fiber. Good nutrition for your family. Blissful honey beans, hygienically packed in 2 kg and 1 kg packet. Stone-free and weevil-free. Pour straight to your pot and cook. Stress-free and convenient. Order online and it will be delivered anywhere in Lagos. For other locations, call 070-8307-6210. Blissful honey beans. No stress.
Welcome back. And as we wrap up this very engaging episode of the 40-plus Woman, I want to say a very big thank you to Mrs. Yinka Olatubosun, who has been sharing her journey from retirement to reinventing herself. Thank you so much for being on the broadcast. Any final words?
Well, final word for women. Make sure you take care of yourself. Make sure you have a future focus. Make sure you invest well. Cash is king. When you need to start business, you need cash. Make sure you take care of your health, because it's only when you are healthy that you'll be able to work. And make sure that you don't have any grudges, it affects your work. And of course, be sure there's an unseen hand in everything that we do. Make sure there's a God factor, you know, that will help and direct whatever you do, as God will direct your family, your husband, you know, and your children. So that as you go along, you have a free mind, you free your mind of things, and then of course you have a focus to do what you want to do, which is your passion. And God will see you at your work to get to the very top.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for being here today.
My pleasure.
And that's how much we can take on today's episode of the 40-plus Woman. And we'll be back with highlights. Bye for now. La, 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 la. We've been talking about the 40-plus woman and retirement plans, as well as how to reinvent yourself. We've had a wonderful guest telling us about her journey and how she reinvented herself. What are the takeaway points? For every woman out there, you must know that as the biological clock keeps ticking, there's going to be a time that in that organization, they're going to look for younger people. And so it's important for you to plan ahead. It's important for you to save, invest in shares, stocks, those things that you can fall back on when you retire. Getting a property is a fantastic idea, because you will be able to earn passive income from your property. it's important that you think ahead. Think about what you will do when you likely retire, because it will certainly come. And one wonderful suggestion from our guest is that having a side business, a part-time business, whilst you're still in employment is always a win-win, because you're going to take your time to build that business. You can put somebody there to manage it or do that business during your free time. And when you retire, you can now go in fully. And then she also mentioned the fact that it's important for you to be a learner. Be ready to learn. If you are now transiting, reinventing yourself to somebody else, to a new field, to a new profession or a new business venture, be ready to learn from those ahead of you. Yes, they may not be as educated as you, but if that is what you are going into, whoever is in that space, be ready to learn. Humble yourself to learn. Also, we need to take cognizance of the fact that you need to join a community. There is enormous power in networks. And I have been tremendously blessed by this episode. I hope you were too. My name is Busola Jegede, and I'm passionate about issues of women. See you on the next episode of the 40+ Woman. Bye for now.
Like a diamond in the rough, you were built up to be tough. You were blessed beyond the cards by the power of the cross. So don't give up on the cross. Don't give up.